Okay, so today we will be doing a forehead reading for Bobby Lee. Bobby Lee is a comedian, American comedian, actor, podcaster, entertainer. Bobby Lee is someone whom I have known of for years. I remember him mostly from his Mad TV days. I have to say, I wasn't a huge Mad TV fan. I'm not a huge fan of sketch comedy, although I grew up watching SCTV and was obsessed with it and love watching it to this day. If only CBC would release the footage from the archives and make it more accessible to watch, that would be great, but. And at the time of Mad TV, I think it came after In Living Color, which I loved that show. And I would watch that over and over. Over Seinfeld, actually, which I think ran maybe at the same time on a different network. But Mad TV was more akin to SNL. Oh, sorry. And while much respect to SNL, I'm not a massive fan of either, aside from the glory days of Belushi and Aykroyd and Chevy Chase and Gilda Radner and all the rest of them, and the early days of SNL, which was when it was simply magic. And of course, the Eddie Murphy years as well, with Mr. Bill and all of that iconic funny stuff. And oh, Mr. Bill, I think, was earlier, but. And Gumby, and but latterly I just seem to lose interest a little bit until the Will Ferrell years, and of course Chris Farley, Adam Sandler, David Spade, Chris Rock that time as well. But yeah, SNL always comes back around, and Fortuna's wheel always dips for a bit with SNL, but then comes back again, especially with the musical guests, etc. But I guess I feel that they aren't as groundbreaking as they were initially. Although Melissa McCartney's Sean Spicer characterization is another iconic classic, and Alec Baldwin as Trump and Larry David as Bernie, etc. But so, yeah, SNL always have something to offer. But I'm not a huge fan of sketch comedy, is what I'm trying to say. After all that, which what and that's what Mad TV was. So Bobby was on there the whole time, I think, and had some really memorable characters like Bae Sung and Connie Chung, and apparently he didn't like those characters so much. And I mean, I think I can understand why. I think if I were of another ethnicity and they always wanted me to play these typical kind of prejudicial portrayals of those of my same ethnicity, I would most likely be offended. Kind of like Dave Chappelle with the Chappelle Show, getting to the point of, well, are they laughing with me or at me? Because no comedian really wants to be made a mockery of in sort of a put downish way. So I definitely get that. But on the other hand, although I can't relate to it in an ethnic from an ethnic standpoint, but from so much, but from a female perspective, if people say want a woman to play a woman or poke fun of things which are stereotypically female, I wouldn't have a problem with that. But then again, it would probably be up to a certain point, and if I felt that I was feeling it, if it was feeling a bit dark to me or maybe seeming prejudiced or bordering hateful, I would recoil. So yeah, I can see where he's coming from as an Asian male comedian in a world where there are just not a lot of people similar to him or on his level. So, I guess a bit of background to him then. He was born, according to Wikipedia, September 17th, 1971. It says in San Diego County, but in the podcast The Fighter and the Kid, he said that he lived in Minnesota for 8 years. So, I think Wikipedia might be wrong. But then again, with comedians, it's hard to know a lot of the time what is truth and what is fiction. But when it's coming from them, so I don't know. But so I came to know Bobby Moore currently via his podcast, Tiger Belly, which he does with his wife, Kalayla. And I'm coming to appreciate him for more of who he is, opposed to this act he always seems to have on whenever I've seen him before. He still seems to always, in a way, be on at all times, but I've come to understand more of the why from these podcasts, and they're funny and interesting, his podcasts. So, for example, when I was first watching, on that same podcast, The Fighter and the Kid, he said he, like, or when I was first watching the podcast on YouTube, I was thinking, what is with this guy? Like, he's such a slob. He pees on the balcony. I mean, what gives? But then I began to gradually understand the genesis of him and more of who he is, and the tapestry began to reveal itself in the interweavings of his upbringing and his life. So, for example, on that same podcast, The Fighter and the Kid, he said that when he was a child, he was molested over the course of a summer by an older, mentally challenged kid that his father was an alcoholic. And immediately I thought, of course he was molested. And I'm really glad he opened up about that because it affects so many people and has happened to so many people. And talking and awareness brings forth healing and change. And I believed him when he said it. I believe that happened to him. So even though it was in a humor-based context, I believe that to be true. So, I don't know if you happen to know anyone who has been molested, and I would never, ever, ever wish that on anyone. And I'm no psychologist, but I do know firsthand and from celebrities too that there's some textbook results which occur from being molested. For example, like Whitney Houston, beautiful, God bless talent, turned cokehead, but then even before that became so full blown, she always had this kind of slovenly sort of way about her in a way that I could never understand. I mean, she was a crackhead, not crackhead because crack is whack, but yeah. So just aside from that, it just always seemed like the whole glam game was a burden to her. So when I watched the Whitney movie and it came out that she had been molested by her aunt, of all people, as had her brother. Who had too that same kind of appearance, that sort of laissez-faire, like I don't give a crap really how I look sort of thing. Like, I immediately thought the same thing. Of course she was molested. How did I not ever even think that? So I thought of Bobby the same way. Of course he was molested. It just all makes sense. So, I mean, this kind of realization does not necessarily dawn on us when we're dealing with someone or watching someone on TV or movies or as a public figure, but excuse me, once it's revealed, it becomes glaringly obvious. So, I thought that was really brave of him to tell that story and risk being ridiculed, which he was, but he handled it well in a humorous way, I thought. So yeah, from my armchair psychologist perspective, and again, having firsthand experience with the matter, I can attest to the fact that what happens to a person when they're molested or even sexualized at a young age is that It absolutely flatlines a person's self-esteem or self-worth. It doesn't just bruise it, it kills it. And how it unfolds after that is often with drug or alcohol abuse, weight issues, bad relationships, putting oneself in not great situations, financial issues, and of course, the appearance thing and other issues as well. It often takes a lifetime or many lifetimes to unravel all this stuff and come to terms with it and finally accept that these things are a direct result of what a person has experienced and not, in the end, a sentence of who they are. Contrary to Dr. Phil, past predictors can be a predictor of future behavior or whatever he says, but excuse me, not always. People can change. People do change consciously as they gather a better understanding of all the whys in their life. And also, we're in this school of life to learn. These experiences, as bad as they can be, are put in place to teach us what we need to know so we can kind of grow and evolve and come to a better personal and spiritual understanding of things. So so it's really important for us to figure out the lesson or the lessons in it all. But on the bright side, it is the perfect recipe or petri dish for making a comedian. Not all comedians have experienced this kind of thing, but I would bet the percentage is high. So this definitely influenced Bobby and his outlook and his comedy. Clearly, he is a wild man. He is always on. I feel like if he could get to the point of really just being his authentic self and not always seeming to feel like he has to be kind of the showman all the time, that he would really rise to even greater heights, I think. He is funny, but if he could maybe expose more of that underbelly of his tiger belly, more of the vulnerability, I think he would have more relatability to a greater audience, which, mind you, I think is what his podcast is accomplishing as well. So Bobby is Korean, not Chinese, not Vietnamese, not any other number of ethnicities. Korean. It's not a race. There are only actually three human races, opposed to what many people think are countless. There's actually only three, which are, I think, Negroid, Caucasoid, I think, and Mongoloid. So Korean person does not want to be called Chinese. A Japanese person does not want to be called, you know, I don't know, Cambodian. A Lao person does not want to be called Vietnamese, etc. This seems to me to be maybe more prevalent in the overarching Asian culture, other than, say, the white or maybe black culture, but it seems to be mostly based on maybe past kind of warring and political history of the countries. But then again, I'm Canadian, and most Canadians are quick to correct anyone who calls them American, for example, so who knows. But anyway, Bobby is Korean. Koreans, from my personal experience, are smart, wise, knowledgeable, a bit crazy, and really good friends. They also have this thing called Han, which seems to contribute to the tempering of their lives. According to the internet, what is it? Han is often described as an internalized feeling of deep sorrow, resentment, grief, regret, and anger. In fact, it's so Korean that there's no equivalent for it in the English language. Well, why would there be? It's a Korean word, so. So basically, it's a combination of anger and regret. And from what I understand, most Korean people feel they have this deep within them. I could argue that most everyone has this deep within them, but the Korean people understand in a profound way somehow that this is the part, this is part of the very essence of every Korean. So anyway, with my kind of limited knowledge of Bobby and just my newfound appreciation for him, I mean, he's been in the comedy business for the majority of his life, I think, at this point. So anyone like that in my book deserves my respect. It's not easy, especially in the comedy world. So that's why I decided to do a forehead reading for him. So let's get to that. Again, just how it all works. I pull pictures from the internet and look at their forehead. Pull pictures of the internet of the people that I'm interested in. I love comedy. I love comedians. I always have since I was about 7 or 8. And so yeah, I love the world of comedy and the comedians that inhabit it. So I just pull the pictures and see maybe what they were going through at the time, or perhaps what they should look at, and read just what is literally written across a person's face, or in this case, forehead. So I guess we'll start with this picture because that's just the one that I pulled up first. I thought it was a really good one. Obviously, he's getting older at this point. I don't know just how recent it is, but you know, he's getting older. And so, yeah. We'll start with the younger ones first. Okay. So this is, I think, kind of round about the, maybe that's when he was doing the whole Kim's thing. I don't know, but I love the mohawk on him. There's not too many Asian guys who can sport a mohawk. Although I have to say Koreans, I mean South Koreans, obviously, and Japanese, they seem to have more of a, just a personal sovereignty and creative freedom to them than a lot of the other Asian cultures, but you really do not see very many Asian guys with a mohawk, so I just love this on him. I think it's so cool. More guys should sport mohawks. Or recently he has a mullet too. He might have grown that out by now, but that looks pretty cool on him as well. I love that he just sort of thinks outside of the box in terms of his appearance, and is unafraid to take risks and do different things. I think that's so awesome about Bobby. So in this one, just initially, I see an M here. I don't know what the M would stand for, but there's clearly an M here. So I don't know if someone in his life at that point has an M name. Or what that M would stand for. But there's definitely an M there. What else did I see in this? You know, I did a video for Norm MacDonald, who just passed, and having trouble uploading it, but Norm had crosses in almost in every picture, I think, really, all over his head, and stars as well. And I was surprised to see them on Bobby too. So I don't know if he is a religious guy, or, I mean, he definitely, I would say, believes in a higher power that's important to him in his life. Like, you know, I can sort of see crosses here. Like, there's a cross here. There's a cross here. Also stars as well. On these celebrities, you usually always see stars on their their foreheads. Like there's a little teeny cross right here. So I don't know, maybe what he was going through. I know he battled with sobriety, but I think, I don't know when he, I thought maybe he resolved that in his teens or maybe fell off the wagon, who knows, but excuse me. So I'm not sure what he was going through at this stage of his life, but there's an M and some crosses. There's like a little star here. It's kind of doot, 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 doot. So up, down, there's a little star. Sorry, my monitor is not that great, and I'm also filming with my phone, which is not that great either, so it's just gotta be the way it is right now. So everything's not as clear as I would like it, but I had thought it was in this one where I saw a picture of a girl's face somewhere up here, but now I can't see it. So I don't know if this was this one or another one, but anyway, that's when he was younger, looking very cute. Let's see anything else. I also get a lot of these sort of like stick figure people, which is sort of coming to. It kind of looks like a little stick figure person. It's coming to sort of mean to me that these people have had probably past lives, and or that they are influenced sort of externally or from another realm maybe or something like that, like that is like a little flower something. So, yeah, where is that girl's face? I thought it was in this one. Maybe not. Maybe we can go back to that one. But anyway, so this is from his younger years. And, yeah, I thought. So, maybe there's some shading. But, yeah, definitely the M is the main takeaway from this one. That's what really stands out. So I don't know what that M was. Or what he was going through at the time that M meant something. Here's another little star on his face. So yeah, another star here. So he's definitely destined for stardom. You know, he's got the stars all over him. And so this, another takeaway when I was sort of looking at all these pictures was that, you can't really see it in this one. This one, what stood out to me was an N. Okay, see. Sorry for this crappy phone film. But there's an N right here. So I don't know what N is. Who, and the N is really clear. It's N. It is N. N. So I don't know what N, or who N is, or who N was, or what began with N at that time in his life that was important. Also, a huge star right here. You see that star? This sort of stick figure-ish person. In a way, I feel like, especially in the early days, that he, what I really see in his forehead, and it's across, this is not the greatest picture for it, but it's, it's right across here and down here. It looks to me like just like this, do you know those sort of air-filled like Those sort of those air-filled big figures that have wavy arms and wavy heads, and they usually put them out in front of stores for a grand opening or something. Like that's sort of a lot of the times what I see on his face, like right here. It's sort of like right here and it goes up to here. And it just that to me just says like he's just feels like he's just gotta be this like wah, kind of guy, like it like it's sort of a it's a person that's not really him. And it like he literally wears that on his face, this almost alter ego kind of thing. And that's who he represents himself to be, but underneath it is just him. So I'm sure his wife probably, I bet, can sort of attest to that. And it just seems to me that that's literally what's on his face. But here's definitely the N. This is kind of this here. I'm not sure really what that is, but. But yeah, this I think a little star there. But again, it's not the best picture, and also my computer is not great. So yeah, those are just kind of a picture, and he's younger here too. This is not the greatest picture. Oh, here's the face. There, it's very hard to see, but there is like to me, just the face kind of a child. At first, I thought it looked like this old girl, and wow, this totally looks like an alien here. Like, there's the alien eyes, kind of the big alien head, alien body. So, yeah, I would say that a lot of his. Who knows? Perhaps he was an alien before. But a lot of it comes through. But yeah, this to me is another face here. And it looks like the face of a child, kind of intermingled with this alien. Like a lot of these things, how they come up is like, can you see that face there? This one? Looks like there's the hair, eyes, and that's this little face. Initially, it looked like a girl, but now it looks like a boy. So perhaps this is the inner child thing, and perhaps just this boyish kind of charm, I guess. So, yeah, that's that. What else is there on here? If I saw anything. Star, 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 star. Also, maybe another little face here. So that's it for that one. There's oh. Who is this M? M? J? M? J? M. J. M. J. Don't know who that is. What I see on him too in his, there's another one I see. I don't know if he has any viral issues. I would say that he has some kind of a viral thing that maybe he deals with. So that on another picture as well. Oops, star. That's interesting. How is that? Yeah, he's definitely got some viral issues, I would say. No offense, Bobby. It's just. I see. Okay, so now he's getting older. This one, I think this one was not easy to see a lot. Actually, almost nothing. Just because the picture's not clear. So, yeah. So this is now, he's doing his Tiger Belly. Oops, sorry. So he's doing his Tiger Belly podcast. And also, the takeaway that I saw from just his forehead too, like what in his kind of younger years, or even still in some sort of more current pictures, but so he's got that showman thing on his, that alter ego on his face there. But what it's turning into is like a phoenix. And I thought that was really wild. It looks to me like he's just like a phoenix rising from the ashes, you know? And so, yeah, like, I mean, even here, I don't know, kind of looks to me like, again, this is a cross. Wow. But it also looks to me like sort of a phoenix rising from the ashes. Like he has, like his showman persona is turning into like this phoenix rising from the ashes. So I think maybe that's more of how he's just presenting himself as more as his authentic self. And he's really coming into his own, it seems like. He's not having to kind of put it on all the time, maybe. He's just kind of maybe more becoming more comfortable in his own skin, it seems like, you know, and more comfortable with who he is, you know. Like I mentioned, especially the with the molestation, it's really does a number on a person's self-worth and self-esteem, and so it takes a long time to kind of recover from that and become able to just accept your that that's just what happened to you. That's not who you are, and you don't deserve it. And then, you know, just kind of work through all that stuff. And it's a process, and it takes some time. And but then when somebody does eventually come into themselves, it's just such a wonder to behold. And it's just really great to see them just be really able to be themselves. And that's really what I hope for Bobby, is that he's just kind of goes more down that path and just really learns to love himself, because and all that he has to offer, because it's you know, he's a very talented guy. So anyway, this one, onto this one. So I did expect actually to see like some, like, how do I say this? Male, the male anatomy on his forehead, because he's very you know, he talks about that a lot, and talks about sort of like sex a lot and stuff. And at first I thought this was maybe a bit of that, but kind of looks like a mushroom or an arrow or mushroom. Yeah, it looks like a mushroom actually, now that I'm looking at it. But this, just this right here, looks like a mushroom. So this again, looks kind of like a person to me. Not sure exactly. I do see two, like a V. I don't know.
little backwards C here. I don't know. It's hard because this kind of his bangs are a bit in the way there. And for him also, see again with him, it's birds on him. Infinity. Heart, either heart or bird. With him, it's I honestly see birds a lot, like, and it's just like he can fly, he's ready to fly, he's taking flight, you know. You see that bird? Even this kind of looks like a bird flying a little bit. Oh, that's it. Yeah. I wonder if he deals with thoughts of, or maybe depression or self harm. I'm wondering. So hopefully not. Oh yeah, so this is that one again. The first one that we began with. So this is where I really, when I first saw it, I just saw the phoenix right here. And it's more like this part of the showman is becoming smoothed out and he's now becoming phoenix-like, rising from the ashes. This, when I first saw it, I thought phoenix, like the head of the phoenix here, the wings. So I think for him, he's really rising from the ashes. I mean, perhaps he did go through a period of maybe depression or I'm not sure, but he's now the phoenix. You are rising, Bobby, from the ashes. You are taking flight. You are on your way. You are good. So that was really the one that I saw this. Like when I first saw it, I thought Phoenix is rising from the ashes. And he's just looking very himself here. Like he's not, like, you do you see in the other pictures that he was really, and I think that's what drew me to this picture, is that he just really is himself here. He's not, you know, doing the wah face for the picture or trying to be, you know, the showman or silly or whatever. He's just looks like, here I am. This is me. And yeah, I really like that. About this picture, excuse me. I really like that about this picture. Again, this looks like a bird too. I wonder if he likes birds. This looks like a bird. Wings. Kind of a baby bird, maybe. This looks like another cross to me as well. See, I wonder if he's religious. What is this? He definitely has a viral issue, I would say. I mean, definitely. Definitely. He has something viral. Bobby should maybe just check that out. Or maybe it's something you already know of. This looks like a star too, actually. Another star. And, so. That was the younger one. Oh, this is Mullet Bobby. And there's not much, just because my computer sucks and it's,
it's hard to see anything. I just like this one because he's got his mullet going on.
This is kind of a diamond here. It's getting to that diamond stage. Something there. It's hard to tell. Viral, viral, viral. Okay, it's viral. This one is really, yeah, this is so pixelated, forget it. Did we do this one? I can't remember. See this again. I see this is viral. Oh, yeah, this is the one I think I saw that. Oh, yeah, and there's a heart here. So he is, he really has a heart, Bobby. He comes across as this, like, you know, guy, or just gets angry or whatever, but he really, I think he really has a real heart. Like a really nice heart, it seems like, because I've seen the heart a couple times. V. Who's V? Wait, V for victory, maybe? V. 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 This looks like maybe two, or this looks almost like a symbol or something, some kind of symbol. I'm not sure. I have to brush up on my symbolism, or even just learn. Oh yeah, did we do? No, I don't think we did this one. Did we? Sorry, I'm forgetting now. So, again, looks like a cross. I think he's maybe very spiritual. Two. What's a two? Is he, does he like the number two? Another two. Is two a good number for him? Two or 22? 22? Looks like 22 to me. Sorry, again, I'm filming this on my dumb phone, so it's not really as clear as I would like it to be. Yeah, he is a phoenix. He is a phoenix. Like, this showman is turning into the phoenix now. Like, you can see the, I know, I can see the phoenix here. The phoenix, like, there's the wings, sort of like the head. And the head with phoenix, you always see the head is sort of tilting sideways. So you can see that it's a bird. The phoenix. Phoenix rising. That is you, Bobby. You are a phoenix rising. There's another phoenix right here. Phoenix, holy moly. Yeah, you are a phoenix rising. That's who you are. Good on ya. Yeah, we did that one. We did this one. I guess this will be the last one. Again, so pixelated. This stinking computer. Do, do, do. Again, I see the phoenix. I see the phoenix. He's a phoenix. There's something there. Again, he's a cross. Virus. It could even be a mindset, you know, a mindset that maybe he has to heal and overcome.
that has kind of permeated throughout him. It might be just something that's sort of a spiritual virus, like something that is weakened him, sort of weakened his strength, maybe spiritually, that he has to overcome and heal from. So I guess that would be kind of my big takeaway for Bobby, is that, you know, just he needs to maybe work on being more of his authentic self, heal from, you know, any sort of spiritual illness or mental illness, or not mental illness, but like something that's just kind of maybe weakened him. But, and the good news is that he is a phoenix rising from the ashes of all of that. So he is, you know, he's a new man. He's becoming a new man. He's coming into his own. He's coming his own person. And like the, yeah, like I just see a lot of birds, a lot, bird. I mean, birds right here. Like, so he's ready to fly. He is ready to fly. So, so yeah, that's, I guess that'll wrap it up. That's the face reading, or forehead reading mostly, for Bobby Lee. Yeah, keep doing what you're doing. You're gathering new fans every day, so, including me. So thanks for everything you do. We appreciate you, Bobby Lee. Keep being the phoenix that you are. Onward and upward. Bye for now.